Hey! Oh, yay. Everybody's okay. Good. That worked out. Hello, everybody. Wow. Everything seems to be working. That's a first, even though it technically wasn't working beforehand. Anyways, hi. Welcome to the Unknown Era podcast.
Ooh, oh, it's started a podcast.
Hey. I, of course, am your host, Martin, and with me are Rick and Rodey.
Ooh.
Am I close enough?
Yeah.
Am I speaking loud enough?
I think so.
Good.
Because if not, then no one will be able to hear your opinions on things, and then it just won't matter as if you don't exist.
I just watched Pacific Rim. That took a long time.
You just movie has been out. You were working forever before this, and you just watched it.
Yeah.
Like today?
Like today, like just now. Like I was working, and then I was sort of going through it fast at the beginning, and then I was like, you know what? I'll just, since it's all done in studio and I haven't seen it, I figure I'll watch some big monsters fight.
Did you enjoy it?
Yeah.
Well, that's good.
Yeah.
It's a lot of monster fighting.
I haven't seen it. Monster fighting. I haven't seen it either, so I don't even know.
Although it's just characters that just flat disappear quickly and you're like, I wish I had more of you guys.
Yeah.
Like the triplets. I was just like,
right, yeah.
There could have been more of you. People just kind of went away really quickly.
Did the triplets just die immediately?
Yeah, pretty much.
Or did they, or they just show him playing basketball?
Were you ever going to watch it?
Yes.
I mean, it's been a while.
Clear.
God damn it.
I fudged it. I touched it the wrong way.
God damn it. Anyways, hi. Welcome to the podcast. We are drinking. What'd you buy us, Roddy?
This is the Mill Street Winter Sampler. So we're sampling.
Okay.
I'm having a boring old tank house, which is delightful because that's just what I wanted and needed right now.
Nice. I'm having organic. I mean, it's organic, so you can form your opinions from that.
I'm having a Schlemhammer.
See, yours is exciting to say.
Schlemhammer Roggenbra.
Have you tasted it yet?
Nope. But before this, I looked on the back and it said that it's a medium copper rye beer, and Roddy said, oh, it's going to taste like pennies.
Hope it will. Mine's creamy and soft. I mean, creamy soft palate. There you go, my bad.
Mm.
Yeah. Does it taste like pennies?
It tastes like pennies. No, when I think about it, it tastes like pennies, but it's just bitter.
I think yours is like, is that
so
strong?
It's just,
No, it's not strong. It's like, that's decent. 5.3.
5.3, yeah. And then I'm going to make Rick play Party Hard today.
Because I
bought it with the winter sale because I've seen this game before and it looks fun, but Rick has no idea what it is.
Have anything to do with that song by that guy that I forget the name?
No.
Party Hard?
No.
What's it by?
Funny thing is that it's called Party Hard, but as the only thing it has to do with partying is that it takes place at a party.
Oh, okay.
Basically, go ahead and hit new game. You can just move forward and hit continue.
Continue.
You can skip the cutscene. It doesn't matter.
I mean, does it?
What happens
if Rick wants to know the story?
No, because we have audio listeners who have no idea what's happening right now. They don't care because they can't see
it. He can
read it.
Whiskey, hold the rocks. Hold the rocks. Hilarious, Mr. West. Fuck you. My name is Inspector John West. I was an officer in command on Party Hard. On the Party Hard killings. Can you describe to me exactly what... Oh, I'm reading too slowly.
Series of murders across the on-break of 2000 exclusively taking place in around house parties, rooftop parties, cruise parties, you name it. This guy was there stabbing his way through the crowds.
I enjoy how you...
I was trying to give it some flair.
Yeah, you went the way you delivered was fuck you was very different.
Fuck you.
Fuck you.
This guy.
Why is he naked? Pixely naked?
He just wants some peace and quiet.
Oh no.
Maybe you should start from the beginning, Inspector. It might give us a better idea of where all this went so wrong.
Oh no.
Basically,
this is a mass murdering game.
Yes. So basically, you play as this masked guy. You can move around. A is party. So if you press A, you party.
Whee!
And basically, the whole point is you're supposed to kill everybody on screen without getting caught.
Without getting caught?
Yep.
But what'd they do to me?
They are partying too hard.
Trying to... Oh, I can't exit.
No. It's all on the same screen.
Could you imagine if you could do that in this game?
You just leave.
You just choose, like, not to abide by its ethics.
And so X is stab. Yeah. But you don't want to get caught, because if you get caught, then... But this is the tutorial, so...
I mean, you could pretend.
But yeah, like, if you party too hard next to someone, there's gonna be like, yo, you weird man, why are you trying to party next to me?
I mean, you could pretend that like all of these people are like cultists and like satanic cultists, and then you're just stopping them before they complete the partying, and then you're like actually saving the world.
Whee! Move to the barbecue trap. Press Y to activate trap. You have to be close to the victim. So I have to be standing next to someone. They like that person. Well, you're lucky that person didn't see you.
You're like soup dupe excited to murder.
I have to be close to.
She's not standing directly next to it, so that's why.
Right.
If you had gotten this guy, you would have shoved him into the barbecue. There. Yay. And then once you kill everybody on screen, you move to the middle of the screen and you just party.
And you party,
because like every, you know, right. Mass murderer.
That's how parties go.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, some good death moves.
I don't enjoy the ethics of the game, but
just wait till you see the next. You see the first stage, because that was the tutorial. Wait till you see the first stage, and then you're gonna be like, "Oh shit!"
Is this like topical to our conversation?
No,
we're gonna be talking about video game ethics.
No,
I mean we can.
I just thought this would be
generally ethics.
I thought this would just be a simple, easy game to talk over. Because there you go, try to kill everybody. So we're already into this, but. I figured we'd talk about is this is the first podcast of 2017.
Yeah.
Happy New Year, everybody.
Woo!
Woo! And so with a new year comes new problems.
What is this topic going to be?
No, I just wanted to talk about general stuff, kind of keep it loose, fast and loose.
Oh, okay.
Basically anything. But we just spent this past week shooting a movie. Yeah, man.
Yeah.
Shooting Rick's film, directing.
The movie's done now.
Yes. Well, it's not done.
Filming is done now.
But yeah, it's super exciting. It was a fun week.
Uh-oh.
Yeah, so if someone calls the cops and reaches, like, they're on their way to call the cops and they reach a phone, then they're going to try to come and find you. So you
I'm just under arrest.
Yeah. Oh.
Oh, that's good. They did their job well.
So, yeah. You got busted. And it shows you how many you killed.
Right, very few.
Yes. But yeah, no, it was such a fun experience. We were in Scarborough, for about 6 days, basically a week, shooting.
Thank you, Rodey. Thank you, Martin.
Welcome. I feel like you want to talk to these people in the game.
I do want to. They have lives, probably. What's this all about?
You can turn off the power. Break electric box.
Just break it?
Like, yeah.
Break an ice box?
And then that way the phones won't work.
Breaking the
ice. I like that idea.
Uh-oh. Oh, never mind. I just made a thing so that if people go to the washroom, they're just going to get electrocuted. But yeah, so we... Every day was awesome to meet with the cast and crew and stuff. Everybody worked really, really hard.
Mm-hmm.
Me and Roddy stayed overnight, which was fun.
Yeah, sleepover.
We watched a movie the first night, and then it was so busy the rest of it that we couldn't get a chance to. Roddy was cooking. He made all our food for the whole week.
That was an experience, guys.
No, I bet you that was an experience. So on a second, Rick?
When someone asked me, did you go outside? I actually blanked out. I was like, did I?
Did I go outside?
I don't know, the whole time.
Oh, whoops. There you go. No, we didn't get to... The only time I went outside was when I went and got... When I had to go do runs for food and other things.
Did you take the firm tofu? Are you making anything with that?
No, we gave that to Colin.
Oh.
Because he said, oh, I actually like tofu. It's like, okay, good.
Still well-deserved tofu.
Oh, no, no. Holy. Why has she stopped calling the poke?
Because they just want to get away from you.
Oh, they just want to get away from me.
Yeah. Because you're a weirdo with a mask and a knife.
Mm.
That person's asleep.
So how do you guys feel that you like the filming is done?
I feel good, relaxed. And also I don't know what to do, and I think I'll probably just do another thing.
Nice. Well, in like a week, editing starts. Yeah. So that'll be a fun experience. That'll be interesting, because it's like, all right, let's go ahead and look at all the footage. Okay. And then you kind of go back and think about, you know, it's an interesting experience once you finally shoot, because the same thing happened with the music videos. Like, you go into editing, and then you finally look at everything. You're like, oh, okay. And you get to think back on how you... Whoa. Did you die?
I died.
Oh.
Did you just walk into something?
I touched a horse.
It's just an angry horse, I guess.
And you get to look back on how you did things and then kind of think like, okay, well, maybe next time I do this, maybe next time I do that sort of stuff.
So like learning?
Yeah.
Learning.
Yeah, that thing, you know. When you learn.
I just can't wait to see it done and cry.
It's very sad. I looking at the footage, some of the footage, just from organizing the hard drives and checking it, is like, yeah, this is gonna be sad.
Yeah, one of the footage that showed me, I was already like analyzing the meanings, like this has this meaning because it's shot like this, and this is, yep, I went hard on it. I was just like, notice how
this means this.
I was like, look at the composition and why it relates to the character. I was like, oh man, I've been in the kitchen too long. But that was fun.
Yeah, being in the kitchen every day was interesting. But
I made banana bread.
You did make banana. You made delicious. All the food we had was just so freaking good.
Yes.
Like, I'm not gonna lie, it was like that stew was at first weird.
Yo, you scared me with that stew. Martin said it was interesting at first, and no one says interesting in a kind way for the most part.
Soup? Because no, the stew.
The stew.
Because he made like normal European stew with potatoes and sausage and carrots and celery and onions. Mm-hmm. But then he's like, all right, now I put in the tomatoes. And I was like, what?
Because it's an Italian stew.
And he told me that. I was like, what else are you planning on putting into this stew, Roddy? He's like, well, there's ketchup. And then there's peppers. And I was like, oh my god, what is this? I'm Polish. This is strange. And so we put in the tomatoes and waited a while. I was like, okay, I can see how this works. Put in the ketchup. And then it went from like super savory and like kind of like, what's the other word I'm looking
umami?
For?
Umami?
Well, yeah, it's umami. It's like savory. But then it went to sweet. It had like a sweetness to it because of the sugar from the ketchup. I was like, we can't put peppers in this. And some people heard that afterwards and like, oh, I wish there was peppers in this. I'm like, why? It would taste so weird.
I think it would add more of like savory effect.
I don't think so. I really don't think. I think it would have made it hotter.
I was just following recipe. Thank goodness I chose recipes wisely.
I think what we ended up with when we added more potatoes back to it, I think then it tasted so much. I think it tasted really, really good, and we got tons of compliments on it.
It's very hard to cook as like a ninja style. it's like, oh dear god, it's sizzling. No.
Oh yeah, cooking while filming is fun. Mm. By the way, Rick, you can hide bodies in the trash cans and in the ice box.
Man, who's these hide bodies? I'm just gonna burn them down.
Okay. This is where we can see Rick's true skin of what he would do if he was a killer at a party.
Yeah.
What would I do? I'd just burn it down.
Wait, why were you watching Pacific Rim?
He saw you, by the way, through the window.
Oh, what an ass.
Yeah, that's why there's that big window there.
Oh, no, he's coming from...
Oh, he got him. One thing about food on set, though, that I think we realized...
People eat?
No, people eat. And sometimes people just don't eat a lot. And sometimes there's some people that eat
too much.
A lot. But then there's also, what was it?
It's a lot of logistics and like weird social. It's like Planet Earth, kind of. Seeing people's eating habits and trying to coordinate it according to people's eating habits.
Well, it's also that we had probably every single... I think we easily had every single...
Dietary
restriction.
Allergy.
Yeah. We had...
Gluten,
lactose, vegetarian, vegan.
Shellfish, peas, nuts.
Man, they got
tree nuts.
We had, like, everything. And so it was interesting trying to make meals that would allow for everybody to be happy and full. So,
But we did it.
And then what else? Also, like, seeing the span of... I know Rodney hated it, but seeing the span of picky eaters...
Were they picky eaters?
Mm-hmm.
They were picky eaters?
Well, Rodney made what was it? You made like a sausage and ham and cheese thing in it, and then you put mushrooms.
I put mushrooms in it, and everyone's like, get that away from me. And I was like, damn it. No one's gonna eat this. But I would put like ham, cheese, and tomato. That's a sandwich. That happens on sandwiches.
That is a thing. It's a real thing.
And then I was like, no.
I just love Rodney's reaction. Like, I want to do this. Fuck people.
But I still did with a smile, but inside I was just like being very... No, I'm not. Not that judging, guys.
You're like, no. No.
I think my favorite part, though, was making tea for the actors. They're so calming when I made them tea.
The actors were so lovely. Mm-hmm. All of them are so great. Like, and we were working with actors that are much older than, like, everybody that was on set working. So... It was cool how they showed respect to everyone that was working day in and day out. And thankfully, being really nice to everybody. And then they're just nice people, like, themselves. So it was cool to work with them and see what they're like.
Yeah, like, I made them tea all the time. But each time I made the tea, they thank me like it's the first time I made the tea.
You gotta hide.
I was like, oh my god.
Hide.
Yeah, he's gonna come to arrest you, man.
Not gonna find me. Not me, no sir.
Where is this? Is this like a...
See, then said screw it and they ran.
There's a British flag.
But yeah, no, filming was fun. It was a lot of work though. Look, there's Mario.
Oh, that's cute.
Is he trying to hurt me?
Yeah, he is.
Fucker.
He looks so regular.
I can't kill him.
He's not as plump.
Oh, he disabled the... he disabled the exit there.
You bastard, Mario.
Yeah, it was fun. Like, I think we're relieved that it's definitely... Because that's the thing, is filming... Like, the music video wasn't too bad. Where it's like... you know, it was only a few days. Movie was like a full week of just nonstop work. You know, even though it was like... For most people, they like came, worked for about 12 hours and left, but still it's like, it's a all day, every day sort of feeling where it's just...
You also worked when there was a snowstorm, so...
Yeah.
Pat on the back.
It also just like, even though, you know, you may like get to go home and relax and whatever, you still, your mental capacity after... working the whole day is like, you're just burnt out. You just don't want to do anything else. You just want to relax and just chill until the next day and save all your energy for the next day. So, yeah. But everybody pulled it off and I'm excited. I'm happy that it's done, but now it's like, all right, what do we do next? And then I just had like, my moment of, okay, well, now I have to get back to real life. And, you know, get back to work and start trying to think of other stuff to do.
All that jazz?
Yeah, all that jazz. You're dead.
Oh, he knows where I am. Yeah. Oh, I tried to stab.
No, you can't stab the cops.
That doesn't make any sense.
But you got more than half. Mm. Yeah, you're getting better. Mm-hmm. Getting better at killing everybody at the party.
Oh yeah, Ryan, yeah. How did you end up watching Pacific Rim? I'm just wondering, because that movie's old. Not old, but it's just like
2000.
It's like not in anyone's radar.
Well, I have to watch a lot of movies for work.
Well,
we go through a lot of movies for work. I can't talk about it.
Okay, fine.
I can't discuss it.
Non-disclosure?
It's confidential.
Confidential?
Yeah.
Confidential?
Yeah, confidential. Filming was awesome.
Yeah, it was just great to, like, kind of get back into the more intense side of filmmaking, and just, like, you're working hard every single day. I really enjoyed that, because I haven't done that for a while. Where it's just like, okay, wake up early, work all day, and then at night you're super tired, and you feel fulfilled with what you did during the day.
Are you thankful not to eat pizza anymore?
Yes. Everybody got to eat. Everybody ate great during the days. And then me and Roddy ate pizza every single night.
We didn't plan the evening.
No. But then we didn't want to eat everybody else's food. And then we were just making everybody's food. So, yeah. Didn't want to.
We ate so much pizza in the span of a week.
Yes, we did. God.
I mean, it was delicious. But every time I ate, I was like, destroying my future, aren't I?
Destroying my future.
But Domino's garlic bread, I would highly recommend anyone who's hungry to have it because it was delicious.
It was really good. Yeah. It was really good. It's like, damn. Yeah.
Carrot sticks? Nah. Just give me some garlic
bread. At the end of the day, I just didn't care anymore. I was just like, I'm just going to eat like a fucking, I don't care. Just because I'm so tired, it's like, I just want to feel. I just want to be full. I just want to relax and, yeah, no, I just didn't care anymore after that point. So pizza and garlic bread was tops. But yeah, it's new year, new times, new chance to start over. No, not to start over, but to improve upon.
Martin's getting
on.
Improve upon
the last year.
Yep.
And move forward towards the future.
Which is weird. So like a blank slate, kind of.
I guess so. Yeah. I feel like the older I get, the more that like I reach that point. Like when I was younger, it'd be like, new year, get a new fresh start. And now I'm like, still dealing with the consequences of last year.
Oh no, yeah. Like there's a certain point.
Ooh, limo.
Where it's just like
killed some people.
Like I gave up on New Year resolutions a few years back. I was like, I rather should start that earlier rather than at the end of the year.
I'm gonna wait till January 1st to fix finally my problems. Yeah. Do you guys have anything you want to work on during the year? Is there anything?
In terms of worky work or just figure out the life?
In terms of yourself, man. Dude. In terms of you.
Me?
Yeah. Yeah, you.
This is a deep podcast, yo. I mean, it does square your thought. You just drop the ball. This bomb of a question. Well, it's not really that big. I'm sure you're thinking about it.
Not really, but the thing that's on my mind now is I'm sort of like, I just want to get back to work. And
I just want to get back to work.
And that's probably not the bestest thing.
You just want to get busy?
Yeah.
Keep working?
Yeah, basically.
Yeah. I feel that. That's what I want to do.
But another part of me is like, but why?
Why would you ask that? But why?
Why do I want to get back to
why?
It's more like I should just take a little bit more time for myself and move slower on some things, I think.
That's not bad.
I don't think. Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Because if you're rushing into something, when you finish everything, on set, for some reason, a lot of people like BoJack Horseman. And the whole commentary about that show is that this guy keeps on trying to, like, do stuff.
Right.
But when he finally stops, it's like, oh, okay, what?
What am I going to do?
Yeah. Like, he hasn't solved the real reason why he keeps on doing stuff.
Right.
So when you take time to actually look back and find out the reasoning behind why you do things, it saves a lot of time in the end. Because, like, you could be, like, 10 years from now and be like, oh, I'm still the same.
Well, it's not, like, a bad thing. I'm not, like, a, you know.
No, yeah.
I'm not, like, upset with the person that I am.
No, that's good. Yeah, yeah.
I want to work. Or anything.
I'm not, like, work has really screwed over my life. I'm like, I should probably... Because this whole time I've been like, I cannot wait until I just sort of do nothing and play a few video games and chill.
Yeah.
And I still haven't done that yet.
You're doing it now.
I'm doing that right now.
Yeah.
I want to work because I want to forget about who I am.
Some people do. Thankfully, we're good.
No, I love work. I love, like, the work that we, you know, try to do and... because it's not just like, oh, it's just work and blah, blah, blah. It's fun to me.
Oh, you're like Morgan.
I guess.
It's from Morgan Freeman and his Oscar. It's because I love what I do. I never had to work a day in my life.
I've never heard Morgan Freeman speak that way.
I didn't even bother to try.
I live what I
that
do.
That was Morgan Freeman. That was clearly, that was Roddy's expression of Morgan Freeman. That's not Morgan Freeman's expression.
He would have said, I'm Morgan Freeman. I've never worked a day in my life because I love what I do. Andy Dufresne.
Yay, impressions. I can't.
Yeah, no, it's like we are the worst at impressions.
That's terrible. I can do some.
Okay, what?
That clearly that okay, I can do a really shitty impression of Sean Connery from Last Crusade.
So specific.
Well, it's just Sean Connery altogether. Like, oh, yeah. I can, but it's only like you can't really talk as Sean Connery. You can only just say phrases. Mm. Like that's the type of impression that I can do is I can say phrases. I can't like just.
Could you try to say like I want a bowl of Tostitos?
As Sean Connery?
I'm just curious.
Well, the way that I do impressions is I try to get into it with the phrase, so it's like...
Okay, I'll see this.
Now I'm under pressure. So, like, in the last few days, like, I should have sent it to the Marx Brothers. He has this Scottish accent. He speaks through his teeth. I would like a...
I just want to see you do it. That's fun.
James Bond. And I like Tostitos. No, I don't think he would ever say it like that. Or my favorite's Christopher Walken. Just because of the way he says things. Just like, hello, I'm Christopher Walken. When I party hard, I like to take each chip of Tostitos.
Like we have a theme now.
And eat it one chip at a time. My favorite is mild salsa. Still bad, but still.
Mild salsa.
I love mild salsa. Salsa.
I just say Sals.
Don't even say Sals. And then there's my Mark Breach. Wahlberg.
What?
My Mark Wahlberg.
There is a Mark Wahlberg?
Yes.
Okay.
Like, so the new movie, what's the new movie is in called where it's about the Boston, like...
Patriots Day?
Is it Patriots Day? It's like... From Boston! Patriots! No, I was trying to be, just do a really bad Boston accent. Mark Wahlberg.
Boston.
Patriots. I don't know. So there we go. That's good. Yeah. So if you want to hire me, I'm available all week. Every minute of every day.
You should go to a party where no one knows you and just put on Christopher Walken. And see if anyone notices.
Hello. I would like to dance with you, sexy girl. Do you?
I don't want to be in the room when this is happening.
Just like, do you know how? Can you teach? Can you teach me to doggy? I don't know.
To Dougie?
To Dougie?
He's not very up in the times. He's like right. A couple of years in the past.
Because to Dougie.
What the? Wait, is it Dougie? No, it's Dougie. Dougie, teach me how to.
Teach me how to Dougie. Teach me how to Dougie.
What's Dougie?
That's a song. It's from a song. It's a dance move, but it's really bad. Anyways.
What's Dougie?
It's a show where Quail Man. Anyways.
Quail Man.
No, it's Bart.
Quail Man.
Yeah, Quail Man, you know, from Doug. The popular 90s TV show Nickelodeon, which goes into our sponsor.
Oh, are you actually doing it now?
No, that was such a happenstance that it just came to Dougie, and now I'm just going to talk about Doug and our sponsor. Nice Throwbox.
Woo!
Hey, do you love the 90s? Roddy, do you love the 90s?
I mean, yeah, I was a 90s child.
Name 5 Christopher Walken movies from
the 90s. From the 90s?
I would not be able to. What was he in? Was he in, what's it called?
I don't know. I'm just putting you on the
was
spot.
Wasn't he in Nicholas? Was oh, he in
we
like,
could we could figure it out.
The Rock? Was he in that? No.
No.
I feel like it could
that's be Sean Connery.
It was Sean Connery.
Christopher Walken. He was in Fat. He was in the Fat Boy Slim Dance. But that would be in the.
Yeah, I think that was early 2000s. Yeah. That doesn't cut. That don't cut it.
That don't cut it.
Is that don't. Day? That don't. That that's their.
Is
that's
that, is that your 90s?
No, that's the 90s throwbox. That don't cut it. So if they're like, "Hey, can we have this in the box?" And they're like, "That's early 2000s. That don't cut it."
No, Sleepy Hollow's in the 90s. 2000s again.
Was it? It was.
Pulp Fiction was 90s. That cut it.
Pulp what? Fiction was 90s.
But Christopher Walken isn't the first. Christopher, we keep doing this.
What's with all Chris, the sass, Martin?
Christopher Walken is not the first 90s throwbox theme. First theme of the year for 90s throwbox is Nickelodeon.
Woo!
So you can get. By signing up at www.90sthrowbox.com, you can get 5 to 6 awesome items. And if you go over there and you're one of the first premium members, you get a premium item. And so if you sign up this month, you're going to get some sweet Nickelodeon gear, hardware. It's going to be great. Things from like SpongeBob, from CatDog. From Hey Arnold. Who knows what you're going to get? That's the surprise. It's a box full of surprises. Who knows Christopher Walken could pop out? I don't know if he did anything with Nickelodeon.
Oh, probably.
Yeah, that's right. Armor Bat. He had a watch in his butt. So go over to 90sthrowbox.com and use the promo code UNKNOWNERROR to save 5% on your box. And it helps them. It helps us, and it helps you by saving money.
Get her!
90sthrowbox.com. Promo code.
I have to hide.
Unknown error. Check out. You only have 2 people left. You have girl and DJ.
He's like, really poor. I know.
Next you, time.
I know.
I'll just catch him next time.
Go up there before. Go up there before Mario fucks you over.
Fuck up my ladder. Yep.
So you just gotta go get this sleepy bitch.
Hey now.
I know.
You're a rock star. Get your game on, go play. Anyways.
All that. I don't know how the lyrics really go.
Glitter is gold.
I don't know. If you can only star in a mold, I don't know.
What?
I make lyrics up when I don't know them. I mean, that's what I did for like O Canada, the French version.
DJ?
You made up the lyrics when you sang the French version of O Canada?
When I didn't know it when I was younger, yes. I don't know now. See?
Parlez-vous français?
We're terrible.
I remember what me and my friends used to do was we'd take... me and my friends used to take the very last line of every the very best word of every line in the anthem and change it to cheese.
Why?
Just because it'd be weird amongst us and see if anybody would catch it when we sang loud. So then when it went to the French one, we just changed the very last line to fromage.
Fromage?
Yes. That
sounds more delicious than cheese.
Oh, can of cheese. Cheese.
Yo, like, lactose-free cheese isn't that bad. I mean, you were trying to eat
it.
I
did not try
it. You were, like, grossed out, but I put it in my mouth, and I was like, it kind of tastes like mozzarella.
I did not try. Yes, I'm back, because cheese is amazing. Y'all heard it.
Did you know there's a Cheetos cookie? I've been looking for a do-it-yourself recipe, but I've not made it
yet. For a Cheetos?
Yeah.
Cookie.
Yeah, it's like, of course it's LA. But now I want to search for this infamous Cheeto cookie for a recipe. I'm nervous to waste Cheetos on a bad batch of Cheeto cookies. Yep, that's my dilemma right now.
Cheetos cookie. Interesting.
I mean, I would eat it. And the thing is, though, you can use the different flavors of Cheetos, like jalapenos. And
you mean jalapenos, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
And I don't know, the other one was Flamin' Hot.
Yeah, that's only the U.S. that has those. I really wish they had them up here.
Well, whatever.
We Flamin' Hot Cheetos. We
got ketchup chips.
We do have ketchup chips.
And all dressed?
You only have a minute and 51 seconds before your heart explodes.
Why is his heart exploding?
Because he's got bomb attached crank. To him.
Why is his bomb attached to him? I think all these whys.
Oh, is that what that little hero dude meant? Mm. Oh, I see.
So the more you kill people, the more time you get.
Oh, I
see. So it's like Crank.
Yeah.
Except not Crank.
Yeah.
It's like Crank, but different.
It's like Crank, but a shittier Jason Statham.
You don't know that.
Don't know that there's a shittier Jason Statham?
I was actually imagining how Jason Statham wakes up in the morning. I was wondering, like, what he does. He must be a cool life.
He jumps out of bed onto his feet. And then he falls over. And then he gets up and he goes, all right, I'm awake. And then he carries on his normal day. And
what?
Nothing else is weird about it.
I would imagine he makes himself a cup of tea.
That's, like, got cocaine in it because he's so extreme.
No, but Jason Statham in Spy is the best thing ever. Did you watch Spy?
No, because it looked bad.
It's actually pretty good because of Jason Statham.
Only my heart wasn't about to explode. I wouldn't have done this.
Go on a killing spree. Stab, 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 stab. What was I going to say? About Jason Statham. No, I wasn't going to talk about Jason Statham.
He's had movies.
He's a ton of movies.
He has had movies, yes.
Mmm.
Mmm. I had a funny thing happen to me today.
Matt Jason Statham?
Yes.
Nice.
That was today?
He came up to me and offered me a cup of tea, and then he asked me if I would
have a dance
just so that I could get his heart rate up so he didn't die. Yeah,
it's based, Crank is based on a true story.
I cranked him hard, gave him good old cranking, you know, just like I just said, you know what, Jason Statham, you're my friend, even though I just met you and this is crazy, but I'm gonna crank you, just give you good old fashioned
cranky doodle,
just like my grandfather used to do. Just crank you good, as they used to say back in the 1820s.
Oh, that's good to say. Back in the 90s when we used to crank people.
Yeah, we'd say bro, don't crank me, and then we'd play.
Where's this going?
Ooh, there you go.
You make an excellent grandpa telling stories to his grandkids.
Be like, don't. He said he's always too old for this shit. No, okay. I'm gonna be. Mario. I'm done with. Oh, he's
gonna be serious now.
He You broke it. You can't use your escape anymore.
Why?
Because Mario is an ass.
He's an ass.
No, but what actually happened to me today? So I thought it'd be fun to get lunch and eat for once. No, that was a bad joke. I thought it'd be fun to go to Subway because I have gift cards. And I went and I saw advertising for their new Chipotle steak and cheese. I was like, that looks like a steak and cheese with Chipotle sauce on it. So what's the difference from the normal steak and cheese and this new one that they're like, hey, this is $3 more. It's special. So I asked. I said, I'd like to have this. The girl started making it, and I'm like, okay, this looks like a normal steak and cheese so far. Before she put it in the to get toasted, she put on Chipotle sauce. I went, okay, that's the normal Chipotle sauce that everybody can fucking have. And then literally the woman behind the counter turns to someone and goes, is there anything special about this sandwich than the steak and cheese? And the woman turns and goes, no, not really.
I mean, at least they're honest for that particular Subway
restaurant. It was $3 more. But thankfully, the girl that like started making it went, that's a ripoff. And then she didn't charge me for it. She's like, no, that's stupid. Like, thank you so much. Because I just wanted to test it. And it's just like, fuck you, Subway.
I mean,
what feeble-minded person are you expecting to get with that? Like, I thought they were going to put on, like, some new kind of sauce. And it's, like, limited time only or some shit. Or, like, put, like, specific cheese on it that's, like, only for that sandwich. Mm-hmm. No. They're just trying to screw you out of some fucking money.
That's weird. So blatant.
So horrible. Fuck you, Subway. I'm still going to eat your stuff, though, because...
Just don't do their specials. Just get what you want.
Yeah. Yeah. No, it was still delicious, though. I would have ordered steak and cheese anyways. But that was, yeah. I was like, God damn it. Why, Subway? Why are you... You killed a chicken.
Did kill a chicken.
Oh, my God!
They attacked me.
Did you die?
They attacked me, the chickens.
Oh, you got
cool chickens.
Did you see what the chicken said? They said, I'm going to kick your ass.
They don't know me.
They don't know me. They don't know where I've been.
They don't know me. Oh, he saw
you don't know me.
That cop's going to come and crank you real hard.
No, not.
Can you hide? Where's the safe,
no,
where's
I can't hide. Space? I'm very slow, apparently. Well, for someone who has there's electricity no running space? Through
them. Eat fresh.
Hashtag eat fresh. Hmm. Yeah. So that was my day. What are you laughing at? That's a solid day.
It was an amazing day.
No, I also tried to hook up. Saturday. So I got. So I want anyone that's listening, and knows tech and knows like video stuff. I got the Blackmagic Deck Link mini recorder, and. Because I know I've watched people online, and I know people have used this to be able to hook up a camera to their computer and use it as though it's a webcam. I got it, and it fucking hasn't worked yet. I tried for like 3 hours to try to get this thing to work. It hadn't. It hadn't.
Oh, yeah.
And, man, because as much as I love our wonderful webcam here, that just decides to change color temperature and brightness automatically and look really grainy and not 1080p. I'd love to use our actual camera.
Makes sense.
So I almost had it working, but then I realized that the widest lens I have is a 28.
Oh, what?
And the widest lens
under arrest. Because you kill people?
Yeah, okay.
And the widest lens I have is a 28, and when I turned it on, it was literally like my face. Just like this. So, need like a really like a wide lens. Yeah, unfortunately. So,
get that 12.
There's that.
Right.
What did you say about my mom? Anyways.
Only kind things.
Only kind things, sir. Your mother is a great human being. There's a bull down there.
There's a bull. What's it do?
Have you ever ridden a bull?
Like bull angry. Ooh.
A mechanical bull?
Oh my God, I killed everything.
Wow.
Wow. Wow.
That was Nutterbox.
Was that a saying that you just made?
Was you just make that up?
Yeah, I guess. And I don't know for sure, but it seems like...
I've never heard of it before.
Well, that's how slang starts, right?
Words just came out of my mouth for no reason.
Sure did.
And therefore, I decided, hey, this is... I'm going to stick with this now.
Hmm.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. So that was my day.
Oh my gosh.
How was your day, Rodey?
Yeah, what did I do? It's pretty chill, actually. Like, I just had to do a bunch of reading, but that's it. I have to watch Chinatown for the first time. I just need to somehow make room for that. I've not watched it yet. Have you guys watched Chinatown? Was it a delight?
Like, not. Like, the original with...
The original with Nick... Not Nick. My God, why am I blanking on his name? Nicholas Cage. Nope.
Jack Nicholson.
Damn it. Nick Jackalson.
Damn it, you Nicholas Cage.
No, you know Nick Jackalson.
Yeah, Nick Jackalson.
Nick Jackalson.
I know the one.
Classic actor. Was in such hits as...
Man, it's only when he's older that he's more of a delight. Because all his earlier films will just wreck you. Like One Flew Over the Cuckoo's Nest, that will wreck you.
Shining. The Shining.
Yeah. Wait, so Chinatown's good?
Apparently it's good, and I haven't seen it.
I haven't seen it in a very long time. I remember watching it forever ago when I was like in my days of, I'm going to try to watch
everything.
And then I got really bored of that because I was forcing myself instead of trying to enjoy them.
Yeah, it's true. Like Casablanca, I still haven't watched fully.
I like it. This is actually something I was thinking today. Where I don't know if I'd want to do it on here because I feel like we could literally talk for hours about it. Maybe we make a new show.
Yeah.
About.
But then I wonder if we could figure out how to do it differently than like this setup. Maybe what? Where we're actually all sitting around and talking to each other instead of facing a screen or something.
Like a round table?
Yeah. Ooh. That would be cool, actually.
But then we have a table. That's how expensive true. Tables are?
Yeah.
Table. We're going to make a really tiny table.
They're like right up there with
it
drawers.
It just has to be round.
What if you have a table with drawers in it?
Yo, then you fancy.
Then you fancy, motherfucker.
Honestly, I have like the table that goes on pizzas. Is that fine enough?
Just get that tiny little thing. The
table that goes on pizzas?
Yeah, you know, the little thing that they put in.
Oh, yeah.
Well, someone just puts it in the middle and it's a round table.
Right.
We just sit around it and talk. We just sit around and talk. But the idea was like, so a while ago, and I know that they update every single year, but there's a book called The 1001 Movies You Must See Before You Die.
Oh, dear God, that's a lot.
There's a lot of movies.
It is a lot of movies. But what I thought is, what if we had a show where we, each episode, maybe we, like, make, like, three episodes where we get through the, like, first 40 years. Because they do it in decades.
Oh, man.
They do it in 10, 20s, 30s, 40s, 50s, and so on.
But what about all the ones I've already seen?
No, you watch it again.
Again?
Yes.
Sorry. No, there's things on the list I could like Escape from New York. For some reason, when I'm watching that film,
on the list.
Is it? I feel like
Sorry, I thought you meant it was on the list.
I feel like it would be because there's certain things that are classics that are like a chore to get through.
Right.
Like, my copy of the book was 20. I think it was 2014. So, but that's back in my parents' place. I remember I gave one of my roommates a copy, but that was like 2015. But so they keep updating it each year, and that's because they don't really change up to like the 90s. But then like the 2000s and now the 2010s, they like kind of alter each year just because, like, you know, they want to make room for new, because it's going to be 1001 movies no matter what.
Yeah.
So they kind of have to alter it. If like a new movie comes out, it's like, this is a movie everybody has to see. Like when I got my book, Black Swan was on the list. And now I don't think it really would be.
It's a decent movie, I heard.
Did that person just walk through the wall?
Yeah, this game is cheap.
What was it? Yeah, I wouldn't mind watching movies, though, to be honest.
But, like, what if we sat around, instead of just, like, you know, bullshitting like this, what if we were at, what if we actually... What?
This was a
bullshitting like this.
So that was my day.
I ate Subway. What?
I ate Subway and tried to make technology work. But what if
you
it was...
Hear new beginnings.
If you go up and stab that... Oh, okay, never mind. You ended up on his head. I was saying, like, if you go up and stab that guy, do you stab him in the crotch because he was spinning on his head? So that was my day.
No, I wouldn't mind watching because I feel like there's a bunch of things that people always freaking recommend that I haven't watched yet.
And then I think instead of just being like, yeah, it was good, or like, that was bad, we like actually score it and we make like a cool scoring like system. One that is hip and awesome with the kids.
Yeah, let's do it.
Hip and awesome with the kids?
Yeah.
About, well, what's good with the kid these days?
Bieber.
Still?
He's growing his bowl cut back.
Yeah, because apparently what? There's a doll that came out that's supposed to be Emma Watson and Beauty and the Beast, but it looks like Justin Bieber.
Oh, that makes sense.
Yeah. Everyone's just like, what happened here? So people just think they just replaced the heads.
What Someday happened here?
He's going to go a little bit nutters and disappear for like 3 months and then return with a massive beard and then people be like, okay, stop making this joke.
I feel like he did that already.
But not with a massive beard, just with a new haircut.
Maybe he can't grow a beard. I don't think he can grow a beard.
No, I don't think so either. But who knows? It could just be a fake one.
I just noticed you trimmed yours.
I did.
You're not a man anymore.
No.
Oh, that's no. Okay. Literally yesterday, I was like, I want to shave all this.
I thought of, you know, I thought of getting back to looking handsome would be nice.
I do want to shave. I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to shave all this and just keep this and this. Yesterday I got so many compliments.
On your beard?
Beard, but then so many people were like, damn, your mustache.
Because you need to twirl it up.
Yo, your mustache is fucking tits. And I said, who are you?
Can you just like twirl it up and just do a day where you just sing like Barbershop?
My name is Nick Jackalson.
Nick Jackalson.
I was in One Flew Over the Cuckoo's Nest.
That's a very hard name to remember, okay guys?
Excuse me.
No, like, I never watched Reservoir Dogs in full. Reservoir Dogs in full. Like, I've always managed to watch the first walk, and then all of a sudden I forget what happens.
Little Green Bag comes on, and then I just black out.
Yeah, literally, I've watched the first half, not first half, the first 10 minutes, like, 5 times. But then I pause for some reason and have to come back to it, and I forget.
I know Steve Buscemi is like a virgin, like a virgin speech off by heart.
Like, there has to be movies that people always recommend that you have. Like, you guys haven't seen Chinatown. Have you seen, what are these popular movies?
There used to be a list.
A list?
Well, no, at the video store I used to go to, it was like, it was the one, the American Film Institute's. Like,
oh, AFI?
Yeah.
The top 100.
Oh, this guy punched me. But they also sort of. What?
Yeah, because there's that movie about bicycles in America. Where. Road? Nope.
The one with the bicycles.
The one with the bicycles.
And they vroom?
Yeah.
The vroom, and they go across the country, and Jack Nicholson's in it.
Born to be Wild? No.
No, that was more of a King Kong movie, was it not?
Was it? Man, there's a lot of AFI.
What are you talking about?
It's just some AFI.
You mean
films?
You know, the one.
Or like Butch Cassidy.
The one.
Sundance Kid.
Where they drive.
And they're on motorcycles.
Yeah, and they're drunk. Easy Rider.
Yeah.
They're drunk and on drugs, and it's not a very good. For me, it was a slog. Because what was the point? Sort of.
Because what was the point?
Yeah.
Well, yeah.
What was the point, though?
No, I agree. Like, sometimes with the AFI films, they're so dated, but, like, Love Story, like, I remember watching that, and I was just like, I hate everybody in this film. And it's the first, like, terminal illness film.
Love Story
with, like, Ryan something.
Gosling?
No. Ryan
Reynolds.
Cranston.
I don't know.
Ryan Cranston?
Yeah.
You, Ryan?
His twin brother.
His twin brother, yeah.
Yeah. Ryan and Brian. Oh, I see. I'm not supposed to be in the party.
The Cranston brothers.
Yeah.
I wouldn't also mind watching really bad films just to rip it apart. Like, apparently the one about Max Steel is very terrible.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
What else? Well, it used to be a cartoon. And it was a toy line. Like, that was straight up a movie that was... Or a show that was just trying to sell toys, and then they made a movie.
Or, like, watching Power Rangers.
Nice! The new one?
Yeah. Or the old one.
The TV show is great. I don't know what you guys are talking about.
I mean...
I have all the seasons right up there.
Yeah. So you would recommend Easy Rider? I mean, it's on the list.
No, I would, you know, watch it for whatever reason.
I think it'll be...
There, you know, that was the nice thing about having, like, doing film studies at one point, you know? It was like, oh, I'm going to watch this because I'm forced to watch this.
No, yeah. Right, I think
that was me with Rebel Without a Cause.
I like that. It was all, you know, it's also a slog to watch, but that's just because teen angst.
Yeah, a lot of teen angst in that.
It's the whole point.
Well, the whole thing is daddy issues.
Yeah.
Entirely. It's the entire movie. It's daddy issues. Yeah, my dad. And then, like, the girl wants her dad to, like, love her. Like, but not in, like, a, I just want you to pay attention to me, dad. She's actually, like, attracted to her dad. And then, like, they meet that friend who's, like, romantically interested in James Dean. But it's the 40s, so... homosexuality is bad at that point. Considered bad. So that was my day. But no, I think it'd be really fun to like go through movies like systematically and like actually like not more like I just think it would be cool to do it on a different kind of way instead of like, ooh, this is a movie podcast, let's talk about it this. Instead it'd be cool to like break it down into a different way. Mm. And then at the end, we can be like, hey, yeah, we watched... No.
No, yeah, because every...
All the movies that you're supposed to see before you die.
And the thing where it's like, Roddy's review, his opinion. Did he like it?
We would review my own opinion.
We would, like, break it down in, like...
Cinematography,
like,
acting.
Well, we would give it, like, a score.
Right.
Kind of deal. But yeah, I think that'd be fun to do. I just have a lot of different ideas for this year.
I want the idea back where we play role play.
Where you do D&D? Yeah, that's...
I've been on about that too, Roddy.
I know. It's probably not going to come back in a video format, though. I think the best thing that we came up with was doing it as an audio format.
I think we should still do it as a bit.
I miss Ivor, man. I forgot to do his name.
Build a set.
Buy a house, build a set, have it in there.
Have top quality equipment.
Yeah.
So that we look nice and it's not crappy.
Tell me the problem with that.
Same problem why we can't have this camera working right now.
This is why we can't have nice things.
But audio would be cool because... Or if it was video, then it'd be cool to do it in a way, but it'd take a lot more time to do it.
That person in the pool with pants.
I can't tell.
Oh, no, I broke it.
Everyone's with pants in the pool. Don't
understand. Yeah, they are. Damn. And then also, like, try to do more live streaming. Like, I think it'd be fun just to do, like, a weekly kind of, like... Like, we do this, but it'd be fun to do a weekly, like, just hang out and play video games. And not, like, post it anywhere, just do it live. Just to, like, chill and play games every week.
What was it? You know what I did enjoy? I did enjoy when we watched Rogue One and did the podcast after. Because it was so fresh.
A 2.5-hour podcast.
Well, because it was...
We talked for so long about that movie, it was great.
No, but it was enjoyable.
Rick hasn't seen it yet.
Because it was so fresh. That's why it was nice to talk about. Like, I wouldn't mind doing it for, like, new movies that come out. Like, that we really want
to
see.
That's just really tricky to do.
No, yeah, I understand.
Going to movies costs money, Roddy.
Yeah.
Tuesdays, yo, or advanced screenings, because they give them for free. A part of me was going to watch Blint because they were offering a free ticket pass, but I was like, I don't want to come down just to see James McAvoy.
Who was seeing who? What?
No, there's a little
split.
Split. Right. Splint? Splitter.
Split. The one where he's a woodworker and he gets a lot of splinters.
Yeah. It's a coming-of-age film.
I would watch that.
I would watch
that. I'd watch that one. So make it, man.
It's what?
Just find James McAvoy and say, hey, I know you just did Split.
So how you feel about
Splint.
Splinter.
Cell.
It'd be like
Splinter.
I feel like it'd just be like smell. Security.
Splinter smell.
I think I'm not gonna survive this.
You just ran into the fire yourself.
Is either that or police.
Those were firefighters.
No, there was a policeman.
Alright, if you say so.
I do say so.
But yeah, it'd be fun to do more like video game stuff just to like give people like something
variety.
You give variety. You could also just fun to hang out and chill and play games.
Can we have a segment where just Rick reads a book?
I mean, you have. We could do something like that. Yeah,
children's books.
Yeah,
I feel like you have a good children's book voice.
I do like children's books.
Yeah. We could also. I also had another thought.
We could just do experimentations. What doesn't work, you just forget about.
I also thought of...
be like, here's Martin Cookie.
What was it? No, you don't want to watch that. It's going to be the same food every single week.
No, but that's the fun part. We like make you cook...
101 minutes of Martin
Cookie. We make you cook like a Polish dish, but then add some like fusion flair and see like this weird kind of thing go on in your brain.
Every week is the same food. It's just made differently.
Yeah.
It's the same meal over and over and over again, but just made slightly differently.
I mean, yeah.
The search for the best.
Blah.
I had another idea. Oh, I want to do more. What I hope to do is if we could figure out a way to do behind the air like every other week. Just like find something to do and then just go film it. Cause we sort of realize like there's some things that like after shooting the movie it's like, man, it'd be great if we had this. It'd be great if we had this. It'd be great if there's this. It's like, why don't we just make those things? So
yes.
I have some ideas in my head about like doing some videos where we make stuff.
Oh.
Yeah.
I mean, like, make stuff, film stuff, or make stuff, like...
Physically.
Yeah, like, we build stuff.
Make things.
For film production.
Honestly, I would like to fucking just either build a goddamn jib or the other thing.
I was like, you know, we were on set, it's like, man, wedges. So simple.
Oh, yeah, those are...
It's like, why don't we do that? But then it's like... I remember we had this discussion about like, man, it'd be great if they had wedges that were like specifically for like hardwood or specifically for this or this or this. And it's like, well, they can't supply that. And I thought, why don't we make our own, make specialty ones,
specialty wedges
for ourselves that have felt or have rubber on the bottom of them. That'd be cool. And then that led to, why don't we make apple boxes? Just make our own fucking apple boxes.
Make apple boxes.
And then we've been talking a while about making our own lights.
Yeah.
And I thought of some stuff today where that'd be cool. But then because we also have ideas about doing, because making a production like we just did took a lot of time and effort and money.
Oh, yeah.
So we want to, like, it'd be great if we could do that over and over and over again. That'd be amazing. But we can't.
Streamline the process a little bit.
Streamline it, but it'd be... But, like, make something that's a bit shorter, obviously, like maybe a 3 to 5 minute thing. And do that at least once a month just to keep the creativity flowing and be able to build our repertoire and get better. Engineer. And so...
I still want to do that.
Yeah. Hmm?
Hmm?
Hmm? But I thought it would be cool, like, to do, like, to work up, be able to work on storytelling and do, like, fan films. So I had a few ideas. I'm not going to spoil them right now. But then it'd be cool to do behind the air on the prepping for those things. And I already thought of, like, the first one. So.
Ah.
Like, in terms of costumes or props or, like, those things. I also just been watching a lot of Adam Savage's
testing. We have to wear costumes every time we make a movie now.
Why?
Why? Interesting twists.
It's not... You can do that, Rick.
I might.
You can do that.
You just have a bunch of wigs and each time it's a different wig.
Yeah.
All of a sudden, Rick has hair. Today
I'm Janis Joplin. And I'm still going to be filming the movie.
But as Janis Joplin. Yeah,
nothing changes.
Me and my Bobby McGee.
Yeah.
Take another piece. That's the only two things I know of Janis Joplin is take another piece of my heart and Bobby McGee. But yeah, like, I think it'd be cool because it's a great opportunity to see, like, you know, us working, and it would at least give us then motivation to try to make some more stuff. So yeah, we have a lot of ideas. It's just time and
money.
Mostly the money. It's mostly money. Mostly money.
Time is time.
It'd be great to not live in the city and be able to have, like, a shop to build things. But, you know.
Yeah.
Because I can't have a table saw in this fucking place.
It's a little tight.
It's a little tight, and then I don't have anywhere to put sawdust. Yeah. You know, that whole thing.
Out the window.
And yeah, I'll just dump it.
No one will notice.
Well, no, it'll just blow in the breeze, and it'll just fly somewhere else, and then it's not someone my problem just
chokes
anymore.
Chokes on it to death.
Whatever.
Local man dies from sawdust.
From
inhalation.
From sawdust bomb dropped off of apartment building.
Like, I didn't say I could do it.
No. And then, yeah, money is such a... money. Because also, another thing that came up as we're reaching the end of this. Another thing that came up. So remember when we were talking about the Nintendo Switch?
Yes.
So today that we're recording this is the 14th. 2 days ago was the press conference announcement thing that Nintendo put on for the Switch where they released like all the details and stuff. So it's coming out March 3rd. And they first were like, here's how much it's going to cost in North America, $350. And everybody went, okay, like, I can see why that's going to cost that much. And it's okay because normally, like, Xbox and Sony are like, and PlayStation are like $500-$600. So people are like, okay, cool. And then Nintendo posted on their thing, they're like, it's going to come out this time in Canada for $400. And everybody just start. I just looked at all the comments and was like, what? Are you kidding me? $400 while everybody else in North America gets for $350? I just looked at all the comments on the Facebook feed and everybody was just like, I guess Nintendo forgot that Canada's in North America. Thanks for getting our hopes up and then stealing them away, Nintendo. So.
Well, maybe we'll get cheaper.
Might. Well, I want to buy it right away.
I mean, I feel like.
I want to get it and stream the new Zelda because I just want to play the new Zelda.
Because like I find
there hasn't been a new Zelda in fucking I think like 5 years or something like that, 5 or 6 years. Don't quote me on that.
Last time I played Zelda was on the Game Boy Color.
Last time I saw Zelda.
Last time I saw Zelda when I was 5. No. It's like the last Zelda was Skyward Sword, and that was on the Wii. There's no Zelda on the Wii U. This one's sort of on the Wii U, I guess. But yeah, 400. No, I refuse. But that's... I'm still gonna buy it.
It's
quite expensive.
That's quite expensive. Like compared to like Xbox One,
that's
and PlayStation.
Food money.
Yeah, exactly. It's food money. Goddamn food money. Mm-hmm. You're taking. But I want it.
Want or need?
I want it. I don't need it. I could probably get away with not having it, but I'd feel left out and sad.
Sure. What happens if it, maybe I would wait and see if it sucks horribly and be like, ah!
It has a new Zelda and a new Mario.
Oh, shit.
It has new games. But, yeah, no. I saw that, I was just like, $100 sucks ass, and I don't know why, because I don't pay attention to those things. So I just see it and I just complain about it. Like, yeah, games now cost like
arm and a leg.
I think like $20 more than they do in the States. That's ridiculous. That is flat out. That is that. No.
Yeah. No fucking way.
No fucking way. But I'm.
Hell no to game costs.
But I'm still gonna buy it.
Yeah.
That's a shitty thing. It's like they can be like, oh, "This is how much it costs," and you're like, "Fuck you." but here's my credit card.
Role playing spree.
Cheap versions.
Oh my god. Are you okay there? Just the way you said that, Roddy.
It's true. Role playing is free.
Hint, hint, hint. Why don't we do that?
No, I won't lie, because honestly, it's the only thing that I feel like sometimes if I haven't like exercised my creative side, I can in it. Be like, I can do anything.
No, we definitely will be doing that again. It's just figuring out in what capacity. But also doing it, we also have plans to do it in, like, a different way, too. Like, a different show. But time and money. Yes. Just two big things. And hopefully 2017
is kind to us.
Is kind to us in those aspects. That we have time, we have money to fulfill these things and make some awesome stuff, because that'd be pretty.
It's a big year, pretty guys. Sweet. It's a big year for you guys.
It's a big year for all of us, Roddy. Who knows what will happen? On that note.
All right, then. Ambiguous cliffhanger.
Rick, how have you felt about killing everybody?
Well, I've been feeling better about it.
You're
not a good sign.
You're getting
you become desensitized to violence.
I mean,
awesome. You're getting used to it, aren't you?
I am getting used to it. So,
just walking around, like, I'm too used to it now. It's just an instinct. I just stab and stab and stab.
I think you're old enough to differentiate between pixels and real people.
Real pixels.
Real pixels.
And let breakdancer go.
But yes, thank you. We'll come to the end of this now that we've kind of talked for a while. But we're prosperous about the future, about this new year.
Yeah, we expect to make things happen because we got it figured out. Oh, it's a tummy.
For you audio listeners, Rick was stretching and his tummy was exposed and that tickled it. Sometimes not. But thank you all for listening and let us know what your hopes for 2017 are. And if there's anything you want to see us do, because we have a lot of plans. So thank you all for listening and thank you to our sponsor, 90s Throw Box. Go over and pre-order the box now because they're going to be shipping soon. They're going to be coming out soon. It's a new year. Time to look back and look forward on the year.
Back and forward.
But getting those awesome reminders of nostalgia.
Back and forth.
And get Roddy's new single on cassette.
Oh, man, let's do that. Let's bring cassettes back, guys.
Oh, man, they never left.
You might get one in the 90s Throwbox. I don't know. I'm just a spokesperson. So go over to 90sthrowbox.com. Use promo code UNKNOWNAIR and save yourself some money on those awesome items. And thank you for listening to the podcast. I'm Martin.
Oh, you want to say their names?
Oh, Rick. Yeah.
Roddy. Yep.
They know their names. And thank you for listening.
Spelt R.
Yep. Now go. No, keep going.
We both have our names.
Oh my god.
You
matching
just.
Matching sweaters.
If anybody's watching this, you know that they're not matching sweaters.
No, I mean, we can get matching sweaters that have an R on them.
No, yeah. You could just get the Team Rocket logo.
Sure. Yeah.
They both got R's on them.
That's true. And they wouldn't be quite as special.
I'm bedazzled. Like those things that you just, like that thing. What's that thing that people use to bedazzle their jean jackets with? Nobody?
Bedazzled
sequence.
Sequences?
Yeah.
Okay.
That's to do R sequence.
Yeah, we could do it ourselves. Yeah.
That would be like a behind the air where we sequence
sweaters.
I'm so jealous.
Then we'll do an M.
You could do an M on.
Yeah. No.
And then you could like put upside you're... down, be like a W if you, you feel change like your name fishing.
Ratten.
I'm. No, you're just pitying me at this point. So thank you for listening to the Unknown Air podcast. Of course, you can catch it live on Saturday nights around 6 or 7 Eastern Standard Time. We're going to figure out that more specific time at some point. But if you don't catch it, it will be uploaded to YouTube. And then an audio version does go on our SoundCloud and iTunes and Google Play. So thank you for listening and watching. We'll see you next time. Bye. Where's the mouse?
The queen wave. That's what you.
Where is the mouse?
You can find it. I believe in you, Martin.
I can't end.
You know, like pretend you're cheese.
End session.
What the hell?
Squish. Like wipe.
I actually don't know where the mouse is.
That's a cut.
Okay, everybody's gonna lick my stomach now.
What? You're only seeing your balls, your dragon balls. It's true. It's right there.
Don't worry, everybody's just seeing
it. And then, like, a bit of my face.
Don't worry, everybody's just gonna see your balls.
It's a bit of my face. My face. My face. It has glasses.
My face has glasses.
So I can see better. One ball, two ball, three ball, four, five ball, six ball, seven ball.
More!
Ah. There's more winter.
Yeah.
There we go.
There's more sampling. Right,
bye. It's the end of the year of our Lord and Savior 2016. I do have Peggle here because I wanted to play something happy and nice as we talk about the shit that was 2016.